Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything, everything. Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything Chris. Everything, everything Chris.
So come with the Slovakia and Europe experiences, what did you experience different in terms of their how they market basketball to over there to the UK? So like what differences did you see that you think right the UK could do a lot more?
Well, you see, the thing is I've been in those experiences, I've just heard about the UK.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But you know, like it, little stuff like you can't get in the gym to work out like whenever you want every day. You know, like we've got massage therapists every single day. You know what I'm saying? Like you can get massage therapists, like chiropractors, like anything you could possibly think of is there for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, and if I wanted to like wake up and go to go in whenever I want, you know what I'm saying? Everything is like taken care of there and then, like yeah bro, like it's just it's prompt, everything is prompt. You don't ever have to worry about anything as a player. All you have to worry about is playing ball, like literally. Like
that's dope, man.
Yeah. And you know, I've heard things about the UK scene. It's just like, oh, you can't get in the gym. You know, you might have 1 hour and a half, like, or maybe a 2 hour slot to practice. But after that, can you get in? Can you not? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you have all those things that you have to deal with. And it's just like, as a player, if you're serious about your craft, you don't even want to have to think about that type of stuff.
Yeah, yeah. You should just be able to access that, like, any other professional. Exactly. It's professional. So it's not like university where you have to time slot and all that. You know what I mean? It's
just, yeah.
I get that, man. So saying that is like, I think with what I've, my experience from seeing what I've seen in UK, I don't think they focus much more on players as much. A lot of the teams over here, I feel they just care about, some of them care about just the money in their pockets. But there are some teams out there that are genuinely care about players. But I just think on the whole, the BBL could do a lot more with marketing players better. Do you know what I mean? Do they do that over in Europe? Do they market?
Yeah, for sure. Because, I mean, like, my first season, like, yeah, totally, bro. Like, first of all, if you're an import, if you're an import means, you know, if you're a foreign player coming in to play, like, for a team, instantly, you know, the eyes are on you. You know, like, all the media, like, is on you. Anything you do, it's highlighted, it goes like to the papers, it's like on the website straight away. And also, yeah, bro, like you're all over everything. As long as you do what you're supposed to do, you're gonna get the publicity that you deserve, innit, and that you need. And yeah, so in that term, I think they do a great job. Like everywhere I've been, France, Slovakia, Italy, Denmark. 100%. Like,
that's good, man. And it should do more I'm saying over here, it would be good for to see a lot more commercials as well with players in it. Like, obviously.
Yeah, for sure. Do you know what it is? Bro, I'll be honest with you. You see, England, yeah, it has so much potential just because we're an English-speaking country. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, when you deep America, you know, like, obviously it's like one or two. Like, basketball, it's one or two. Do you get what I'm saying in terms of, like rankings in sports, like
one or two, because basketball and in America, football, baseball, one of the other ones. So
in England, yeah, a lot of people actually like ball, bro. Like they actually like basketball, but
they don't know
where to find it, bro. Do you get what I'm saying? Like they don't know where to go to look. They don't know where when a game's playing, where it's being played. Do you know what I'm saying?
This is what I've kind of preached a lot as well, because they don't. There's a lot of people that I tell them there is, and they didn't know there's a professional league, and it annoys me. It's just like, what? And then they don't know where to find it. There's some people in the areas where they live, they're like, Newcastle, I don't know, the Eagles, I didn't know they were called Eagles. It's like,
do you get what I'm saying? That doesn't make no sense to me. Do you get what I'm saying?
And what hurts most as well, I've been to a scrimmage one time and I tell them, yeah, I'm going to watch BBR and did it. BBR, I don't know about that. Who plays there? And it's just like, what? Like,
yeah, it's frowned upon, isn't it? It's frowned upon.
It's like, hold on.
But do you know why though? It's because there's not enough financial backing behind it, bro. Like there's not enough people. You know, you got homegrown talent like myself. Do you know what I'm saying? Like a bunch of other people that. It's not that like we frown upon the league or like we look down upon playing in England, bro. Like everyone would want to play in England, bro. There's no one that can honestly tell me with their heart, I want to go to Spain or I want to go to Italy or France. Or don't get me wrong. It's dope to be experiencing the world and traveling the world and getting paid to do it. But at the same time, bro, like if you can play in your home country, why not? You know what I'm saying? Like, why not? You want your fam, your brothers, your friends, your boys, you know, your girl to be at your games here. Why wouldn't you want that?
There should be more focus on the players, man. That's exactly what it is, man. That's it's good though that you had some people like Justin come back home, and then he won MVP twice, and that was a monument moment, man. Because that's going to be remembered for time, like as opposed to 100%. someone who scores like me and Ishmael talking about it, someone who scores 20 points a game on a losing season, three seasons in a row. No one can remember that. You know what I mean? The fact that it's Justin, he's English, and he's down to earth.
He's almost like a hero, bro.
That's it. Yeah, so I'm saying, and that right there should have been publicized. Like, bang, got a hero here. But
yeah, 100%. And it does. I think it does. Even when you know Matthew,
Matthew won when they won that cup, that should have been.
Yeah. When they came back and they did their thing, you know, I'm sure like they had people like. Wait, hold on. You know, is there room? Like, can people really come back and, like, play in England and like, it'd be worth it? But, you know, it's sad that, you know, that situation ended the way how it did because I'm sure a lot of people was feeling like, there might be hope. You know, there might be an opportunity brewing, like, for me one day or something like that. But
yeah, man. Again, I think with... again, I'm mentioning him again because he had some great points. Ishmael mentioned again. I think with that London Royals thing, he felt like they threw money at a problem that wasn't like instead of trying to. Trust me, yeah, I think they threw money at the problem. If you know what I mean, instead of getting to the grassroots, I'm thinking of long term. It's just like, oh, let's put some money in, and this will help the BBR. Money's not going to help. Money's not the issue, man. It's more about what we, how we portray it, how we market it, how we push it, what we're gonna do in the future. Because the money.
When you say yeah, you feel like they threw money at a problem. What do you mean?
I think like instead of fixing what the issue was, like fixing the grassroots, they just thought, oh, let's cover it up with some money. If you know what I mean? Like it was BBR.
The thing is, everything has to get covered all at once, though. Do you know what I'm saying? Like it because. Hear what I'm saying, where like I hear you with the grassroots, and I feel like it definitely does have to start there.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, the game's about entertainment, isn't it? Do you know what I'm saying?
100%.
Just entertained, and the better players that you get, the more entertaining the league's gonna be. In order to get those entertaining players, you're gonna need to be able to pay them. Do you get what I'm
that's
saying?
True, because that's
if you
true.
Don't pay them, then somewhere else is gonna pay them, and they're gonna go where they're gonna go else. You know what I'm saying? Because you can't tell someone, bro, come back for the love. You know, or come back to... No, it's true, though, bro. It's a business.
I know what you're saying. It's like the sincere talk, yo, come back for the love, bro.
Yeah, come back for the love. Come back to help out. Come back to help out the community, bro. Like, come back to help out. I know you seem like a down-to-earth brother.
Yeah.
But that same down-to-earth brother, he's got a family that he needs to feed, so...
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So the thing with Royals, I think they did a good thing. They should have capitalized off that, but I don't know what it was. They've tried to fix something again that wasn't broken. And that's another thing I've seen a lot of times. It's like, oh, we're going to get rid of this. It's like, what are you fixing? What are you trying to... It's like, your oven's working perfectly fine, and a man's going in there trying to unscrew that light, and then the grill, and you're like, bro, what are you doing? The oven works fine, bro. Like, why are you trying to fix it for? Now you've broken it just by trying to fix something that wasn't broken. And that's what that's an issue that happens. It's like, what are
you, man?
It's like, what are you doing?
The levels for the kids to aspire to become, and like if you got guys out there playing for free, they're not gonna really want to aspire to that, because you have to remember, yeah. All right, it's just like the rap game. It's just like, you know, the football players. And why do you think, apart from you got every kid out here is on a green playing football? Why? Because you know that. By the time you get 16, 18, if it pays off, it's going to pay off.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Now, what, you feel like, dudes love playing ball, bro. Do you know how many of my friends that are cold, like, that I grew up with, and they were nice ballers, bro?
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They were nice ballers, bro. Like, I'm talking, I can hand on my heart, yeah, say some of my friends were way better than me, fam. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And they never got the opportunity, maybe because they stopped, because they didn't see a light at the end of the tunnel. And guys before them, yeah, they're looking and they're just like, well, you're playing here and you're not really getting paid, bro. I got guys that are on my block that are making more money than you're making. So, and that's what I'm saying, like, where we come from. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get that.
Where we come from, yeah, we play with a chip on our shoulder because of everything that surrounds us. So if you're around certain, like, you're coming back from training and you're seeing certain guys that you chill with and they're making a certain amount of money, you're feeling like, does it make sense me continuing to dribble?
Yeah, I get what I'm saying. 100%.
And then a lot of them drop off like that, but then it's like, when they see someone like myself, like, do what I do, yeah, and then they're just like, and I'm playing for everyone else. I'm playing for all my guys that wasn't able
England should be marketing that, like, bang, regardless if he's overseas, look, man, he plays overseas. You know what I mean? This is what he does. If you work hard or work on your craft, you can get to where he's getting to. I don't think they do that enough in this country as a whole. So it's not just BBR. It's like, there should be marketing that, man.
100%. But you know what, though, bro? Do you know what, though? Like, I've always been someone that's kind of like, I'm kind of to myself, innit? Do you get what I'm saying? I do what I've got to do. And then I bounce, I go back to what I'm doing, and that's how it is. Do you get what I'm saying? And I feel like the scene, like the English scene, the basketball scene, they kind of like, they don't really like that. You know what I'm saying? They like guys that are kind of like buddy-buddy all for them and all of that type of stuff, trying to push their agenda. And it's like, when you got guys that are really like true to it, it's not really, or they might be a little bit rough around the edges, it's like, and they shy away from it, so... You know, I kind of feel like that's why certain people don't really get the accolades and, you know, the love that they deserve from the actual, you know, industry.
Yeah. 100%, man. I agree with that as well. Definitely 100%. All right. Let me go on to my hotspots now.
Everything, Chris. Everything, Chris.